Hey, how you do? How y'all doing? This is Hatezu Israel, and this will be the Leo Dragon. One of my favorites. My firstborn is the Leo Dragon. Shout out to you, Faith. Love you. Hopefully I see you again. Life is hard on your dad. I know you're gonna be 9 this year. Just endure. I hope to God that you find me, because I miss you so much. And I'm gonna show the world, you know, our videos. But I got a Leo dragon right here, so let's go ahead and get to it. The Leo dragon. This word here, I'm kind of slow, y'all. Let's find out what that means. Intuitive. All right. Oh no, come on. All right, let's go ahead and get into it. Anyone born between July 23rd and August 22nd is a Leo. All right, and these are the dragon years. My firstborn is 2012. Everybody thought the world was going to end that year. I did too, boy, I tell you. I'm like, man, I gotta find my woman quick. You know, I was depressed and miserable. And I'm like, man, I want children bad, man. I want children. God gave me a child. Hopefully God be able to return her back to me, man. Right now, I don't know what's in her mind and what's in her spirit, but hopefully she be able to return back to her dad. Let's see here. Dreamy, but organized. And you're gonna find that in her nature, okay? She was 6 years old. She always had this like dreamy type of vibe, even when she was when she was a baby. You know what I'm saying? She had a very dreamy like nature, and it was very invigorating hanging around her. Like, I had a very strong, special bond to her, and I love taking her out to eat. She made me feel really good. Like, she made me feel like a proud dad. But I've never really met an older Leo dragon, you know what I'm saying, that's a male or female that could bring up those same qualities. But far as, like, my firstborn, you know, she brought that side out of me. I felt very, very at peace around her. And it says these people could be intellectually challenging. Let's see what that means. Because I'm trying to see what is it like when she steps deeply into her womanhood, what that will look like. Phone freezing up, hate that. Intellectually challenging. It shouldn't be this hard to find out what a word means. Just my phone is just on some nonsense right now. Hate that. Appealing to or engaging the intellect. So it's a possibility. And you're gonna really hear how she talks. You know what I'm saying? She really is very smart. You know, very smart. Oh Lord. Sorry, I'm just got to refresh again. But actions speak louder than words, of course. Not every Leo is the same. Not every Leo is going to bring out the best results. Some Leos will drive you nuts. and take your nuts and eat them right in your face. Seriously. Intellectually challenging. It's just like, yo, just that word, just, it's like, I want to learn, I want to find out what that is. Intellectually challenging. I'm just blown the hell away. I mean, involving a person's ability to think and to understand ideas and information. An intellectual is someone who spends a lot of time studying and thinking about complicated ideas. She's a very creative young lady. I don't know where she's at now, but she's very, very creative. And I would love to meet her again. I didn't know that How you doing? It's looking good?
Good.
Awesome. Yeah, that J1, it just takes majority of your time because you gotta...
Oh, no, you're good.
Yeah, that thing's a headache sometimes.
Just like when you start getting to the cans,
bro. Oh, man. Whew. Hey, I don't know why they put the cans, like the small cans at the bottom and the big ones up top. I don't know who thought of that one. Interrupted because unfortunately I'm 1 o'clock. So let's get back to you, Leo Dragon. This one may be time consuming because I actually helped put a Leo Dragon on this earth. And at first when I've met the Leo Dragon, it wasn't a pleasant encounter. Very, very, she was very cautious. When she like saw me for the very first time, she was like, yo, who the hell is this? Started crying. But then again, I've used my tactics to try to get her to open up. You know, because it was like very difficult trying to pick her up and engage her in a father and daughter relationship. So she did open up, and we were at the Chuck E. Cheese, and it was her curse day, of course, her B-day. I don't do birthdays, but it's good to use when you don't know nothing about an individual. So sometimes you may need a person's birthday to see who and what you're getting yourself into so you can actually break down the eye to horoscope on them. Okay? Like you were witnessing today. So it says, can be intellectually challenging. The Leo Dragon Woman is very straightforward about what she wants. Do any of y'all out there know what the word straightforward means and what it looked like into action? What does straightforward means? When a person is straightforward, what does that actually look like? What does it feel like to be a straightforward person? Let's see. Uncomplicated and easy to do or understand. Because, when me and her ever step out in public, people were very, very angry and jealous of our connection. Very, very disturbed. Hated it. You You know what I'm saying? And she was very happy that I was her dad. Very thrilled that someone like this brought me on this planet and gave me life. I don't know what she's thinking or what she's feeling now, man, because I fell on hard times. But, you know, those of y'all who got a Leo dragon son or daughter out there, and you are similar to I am, because every Leo dragon is not the same. Okay, every one of them come from different walks of life and backgrounds. You know what I'm saying? All of them are not like robots. You know what I'm saying? It's just the types of y'all that are out there. Y'all may feel and do different things. Y'all may be going out with different types of people, dealing with different types of people. You may have a different type of nature. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying that everybody's the exact same duplicate. I'm just showing y'all that this is what you are, that there are 12 different types of Leos out there. Or I should say varieties of Leos. Or if I'm saying it right, who cares? But you know, this is what it is right here. She is a people person. Definitely is very, very sociable. You can make friends real quick and enemies very quickly. And as she stands up against bullies, you know, I believe I witnessed that. You know, when I heard her words, when she wrote on a piece of paper, it brought tears inside my spirit. You know, I was blown the hell away that, you know, the person who I brought here knows how to talk. But now, I don't know what she's going through right now. You know what I'm saying? Y'all just pray for me, man, because it's very difficult to be in touch with a Leo dragon. Because sometimes they can be kind of harsh and cold and dismissive and not take you serious, too. Because when she gets around her peoples, she's like, yo, dad, get out of here. And it hurts and it crushes my spirit that, you know, she don't want to be around her dad. You know what I'm saying? It's like sometimes she do, sometimes she doesn't. Sometimes Leos, man, they just want different varieties of people that they want to kick it with, hang out with, you know what I'm saying? But when they are with you and they having a good time, they will give you joy. That is for a fact. So they are straightforward of what they want. That is evident. I've actually witnessed a Leo dragon actually embracing that nature. And this is the Leo dragon man. Let's see. Otherwise reserved. The Leo dragon man doesn't shy away from challenges. Because one thing about my daughter, man, is that when I took her to the Ohio State Fair, she was very disappointed and upset that she wasn't tall enough to get on certain rides. Because if she was tall enough, man, we'll be getting on all the rides at the fair, having a ball. But since she was young and she was short, it was very frustrating and I felt her pain. And she was with her auntie, because I'm a nice guy. I was with her auntie and, you know, I spent some money for her to enjoy herself at the fair. And she was just too damn scared. She just wanted to eat and sleep. But my daughter, man, she had that thrill. She had that drive. Like, yo, I want to get on every ride. I want to see what kind of snacks they got. But she was wanting to, like, get on the rides. And I felt really bad because, like, you know, I'll be able to connect with her very well. You know what I'm saying? Especially when she's having a good time. You know what I'm saying? Leo dragons, man, you can have a good, enjoyable, refreshing time with them. You know what I'm saying? Majestic beings. I wonder what that means.
Majestic.
I'm sorry, majestic. Got corrected there. That was a strike to my pride. All right. I'll tell them about some majestic. It said majestic. Boy, I shouldn't even open my mouth. Having or showing impressive beauty or dignity. these are the words right here, just in case, you know, you're not using that in your everyday speech or understanding of vocabulary. Let's continue on, because I definitely got to breeze through this and show y'all celebrities who are Leo dragons. I may have to show a video because, you know, not showing or embracing favoritism for all the signs, all the 144 of them, but some of them I just gotta go more to depth, you know? And I'm compatible with a Leo. So it makes sense that, you know, me and my daughter, man, we have a good connection. And you will see that me and her vibe very well. We vibe very well. It was beautiful. And you will see the video called Eggnog Soda, where me and her went to a coffee shop. And drunk some eggnog soda that tastes like a bar of soap. that was a very, very funny video. Y'all would probably be cracking up if y'all saw that. So this is how a Leo dragon will get a reaction out of me. I don't know, I can't speak for all of y'all, but if you know exactly how to communicate with me, we can do many things. Go very far. They have something royal about them. So my daughter did have like some sort of a royal nature. And it was mind blowing. Like, even when we just, like, if, for example, we sit on the couch and talk, you know what I'm saying? She would hear you talk, and then she'll give her feedback. And that's like a technique that I sometimes would use, depending on the conversation. Because if it's stupid and it's irritating and it's bringing an unclean spirit into the forefront, I have to dismiss you and get the hell away from you. Let's see, they are natural born leaders, just like the Leo, but at the same time, they're not trying to impose the force that characterizes them, so they are tempered and composed like the dragon. Let's see, what does the word tempered mean? Let's find out. Let's get a definition.
Tempered.
Wow. I've never seen a definition look like this before. We're definitely in the end times. Okay. Let's move on. I guess we're just going to be confused on that one. But I will say tempered could mean balanced. That's just my guess. I could be wrong. That means you have gravity. Nobody can move you or get you out of your shell. And boy, she could be a prankster, boy. She could sometimes get on your nerves, like play too many games. But they're a whole lot of fun, and it's very hard to be mad at them. You know what I'm saying? It's very hard. Because you find their spirit and their nature so invigorating is that it's like, man, I just can't be mad at you long. Even if they did something bad, man. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, I just don't want to be angry at you long. I just can't. So, it's just very hard to be difficult. I mean, it depends on you, because I don't know how your experiences are. I'm just sharing some commentary on this thing. I mean, you can do your version of the Zodiac breakdown if you want. Says these personalities are sometimes dreamy and can easily get distracted pursuing some idealistic challenge. She can't get easily distracted. I have noticed that. Because, like, whenever we go shopping or going to a grocery store, you know, I had to put her in the cart. Because if she was walking, she ain't going to follow behind me. Her mind is going to be like, ooh, I wonder what that is over there. You know what I'm saying? She would not follow the leader. So sometimes I would have to hold her hand and be like, hey, come this way. Where you going? You know what I'm saying? They is easily distracted because there are other things that are on their mind. Okay? You know, that's how they are. Let's see what that word optimistic means.
Optimistic.
Cheerful, positive. So she did have this bubbly, beautiful nature about herself. You know what I'm saying? And you will see that. You know, when you'll see the videos of the reaction of a young Leo dragon. I don't know what an old one is like. I don't know how they would feel in this society or what they're going through. But I guess I'll get a snippet of how one is in the older version. I've experienced a young version of Leo dragon, but I have not experienced the version of an older Leo dragon. Okay. And often people could accuse them of not being too serious. Sometimes she don't really take things serious. You know what I'm saying? So, boy. Sometimes they can be very, very difficult to raise. Very difficult. Because, like, you know, even with raising her on how to take care of her health and what to eat and everything like that, she would get persuaded by her other parents and don't let it be known, like, hey, this is what I feel is right and I believe dad is correct. Sometimes she would get swayed and persuaded to go against what I taught her. And that's a sign that she don't take things too serious. So sometimes she don't listen to what her parents say to her. You know what I'm saying? And she ends up in trouble and confused. You know what I'm saying? And you have to be constantly on them, and they need discipline and they need love. And, you know, when they lack the love and they lack the discipline, they are going to be confused of what's right and what's wrong, what's good and what's evil. And once they have practiced something so long, you know, it's a possibility that, you know, a lot of them can be on drugs, cigarettes. You know, they could be very depressed and miserable because they didn't have that mentor that was on them, coaching them, letting them know this is the right or this is the wrong way. You know what I'm saying? So they have a nature where they can be easily distracted, meaning that you teach a Leo dragon one thing, somebody will go behind your back and teach them another thing, and now they're confused and don't know what the hell to do. You know what I'm saying? So unfortunately, that's a lot of your nature. You know what I'm saying? Y'all have that nature, that's what y'all do. Unfortunately. More than this, they could be insensitive with their words and actions affecting others' feelings. Because sometimes she could say some things that be like, hold up, what? And sometimes when I was off work, you know what I'm saying, I always get confronted. Like, oh, what she do now? What's going on? It's like, you know, it's like they get themselves in mischief. And it's like when she was around me, she seemed like she was cool. And some people be like, well, yeah, since she's around you, she act like she's an angel and she all innocent and all that. But behind your back, man, she the devil. I'm like, okay. I'm like, you know, like a lot of us, man, we'll get offended when people tell us about our children. You know what I'm saying? And I'm that way. Like, I'm like, you know, this is my firstborn. This is my family. You know what I'm saying? And if you talking and you dogging the shit out of her, you dogging the shit out of me, because I know, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's not cool. So of course you're gonna stand up for somebody who you brought on this planet. You know what I'm saying? That's only natural. You know, that's your family. That's who you got. They bring things out of you because you love them. You know what I'm saying? But when somebody talk bad about somebody who you brought here on this earth, you know what I'm saying? You're going to be on the defense. You're like, no, dog, you wrong. You wrong. Don't talk about them like that. You know, that's your nature. That's our nature. Even when they are in the wrong, we still defend them because we love them. You know, you're going to defend somebody who you love and who you brought here on this earth. Even when your son or your daughter is a demon, you know what I'm saying? You're going to defend them. 9 times out of 10. And these are the words for insensitive. I'm sorry that I'm giving so much extra narrative and commentary on this, but I really, really, really love the sign of the Leo dragon. And it has changed my life that I have brought one on this earth. You know what I'm saying? It really has. And I don't know how strong I gotta be, man. I really don't know. But it's just a lot. They don't know their way with words. Yeah. I mean, they do. They got that nature, man. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes, you know, everything ain't 100%. You know, nobody's perfect. Nobody's connection's gonna be perfect. But it could be very, very strong more than it is weak. And it could throw people off. And that's what it did. Like some, like for an example, you know, some years back, you know, me and my daughter was outside and I was pushing her in the cart and somebody stopped their vehicle and saw us pushing my daughter. And she just gave me $20, just gave me a $20 bill. And then there was another scenario where a woman just literally just stopped and gave us a ride. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, some people love the connection, you know, seeing a father and a daughter together, and they can see the spirits together that's complementing each other. They see the spirit of the father and the daughter complementing each other, and it's some people, they have a, you know, it pulls on their heartstring. They love it. Some people, it eats them alive. They hate it and they despise it. Let's see what their top characteristics are. You can read this whole article on your own. I'm just basically giving commentary. Those of y'all who are Leo dragons, you guys are in luck. You ladies are in luck. You're probably going to love this video. Some of y'all are going to hate it. I don't really care. But my life has totally changed. Bring one on this earth. It is dramatic. It changed. Man, can't even say it in words. It's been amazing. Let's see. Compassionate. These are the characteristics. Okay. Let's see, aloof. So she also had this nature, and I always wonder why, you know, she behaved like this. So I tell you guys, you need to do your research on your family, on your friends, on yourself, and on your people, because you can learn a whole lot. You know what I'm saying? You need to learn yourself. Because you can get yourself in a world of trouble, in a world of hurt. And some things is out of your control. You know what I'm saying? I'm not a psychologist, but it's in my nature that I probably have been one. Where I was able to give people a strong understanding about themselves. Now, back in the day, in my younger days, I never did stuff like this. Now that I got older and wanted to find out what's going on and why I behave the way I do and why my communication skills are so freaking strong and effective and deadly, I had to research it. I had to find out, like, why. You know, and I had to find, I thought I was the only one on this planet that everybody hated, they couldn't understand. But I had to do some research on myself. Why I act the way I do, why I communicate the way I do, and why some people just know damn well for a fact that they should have never let me go. They done fucked up. They messed up, just let me go like that. Because the money was an issue. But they didn't know that I had a God in heaven that was watching me. And now they see the God in heaven revealing my gift, and my life is changing, and now they're hunting me down, trying to figure out what is going on. They feel it in the atmosphere like, yo, I'm sorry, I fucked up, please take me back. No. No, that's not how this works. I don't give a damn how broke a person is, how much they have fallen on hard times. As long as they are communicating with me, I don't give a damn how financially fucked up they are. But at least if they're trying to make improvements in their life and not trying to stay where they at, and they not tuning me out and acting like I'm a nobody and putting people before me, you know what I'm saying? You're gonna be cool. We're gonna have a good connection. But only time you can put things before me is when you're taking care of your business and you're trying to get your foundation right in order. I can understand that. But when you are putting people before me, you up here flirting with different types of people and I'm a nobody, I can't take you serious. You know what I'm saying? And one thing that a Leo will do, sometimes they will drop the ball and they don't know how to keep the connection. You know what I'm saying? Because they got so many different types of people on their mind. They're natural born people pleasers. They're superstars. They like the spotlight. You know what I'm saying? Let's see, strong. She do have a strong nature. And when I see that and I feel it in her spirit, I was blown the hell away. I saw something in her that I ain't see in my mom or my dad. And I'm like, yo, this right here could be my sister. You know, I felt more than this just a person who I brought on this planet. I really felt like she was family. You know what I'm saying? This is somebody who I need in this life that can really get me in order, that can get me straight. Even when I was very shy with women, man, she'll put me on blast on the bus. She'd be like, hey, you know, you like my daddy? Can you be my daddy's friend? She'd do stuff like that. She'd be a wing lady. I'm like, what you know about being a wing lady, man? You too young. But that was in her spirit, man. It's that she know how to connect the dots. Her network was strong. You know what I'm saying? Networking and communicating is two different things. I hope you guys do know that, because a person who networks, they don't give up. They keep on going. They keep on going, no matter what. Sometimes I get tired of reaching out. You know what I'm saying? I get frustrated. But Leos, man, they got that gift. They got it in them like, yo, I need my people. I need my posse. I need my peoples. And 9 times out of 10, sometimes they get themselves in a lot of trouble. They end up owing people, and they put themselves in a lot of drama and a lot of chaos. You know what I'm saying? Because they try to be people pleasers, and they get themselves jammed up. Sometimes they end up having hella kids by different men, and vice versa. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes, you know, they can be off, but they are strong. Like when you get around them, when you get around a Leo, a real Leo, the real deal, king of the jungle, queen of the jungle, you're gonna feel it, and they're gonna make their presence known, and you're gonna know. You're gonna know that thing, you're gonna feel that thing. Even my brother, he's a Leo. And I may touch on his video as well. Okay. They are strong. And it says realistic. I connect people who are real. You know what I'm saying? She's realistic. Even when she's goofing off, you know what I'm saying, doing something she ain't supposed to be doing, but she's still realistic. You know what I'm saying? There's nothing fake about her. She keeps it genuine. And I can see it in her soul, man, that she's the real deal. You know what I'm saying? And she will embarrass you. She will, like, you know, dismiss you. She sees somebody who she like, or he, you know what I'm saying? They will move you out the way. They'd be like, yo, you know, holler at you later. Somebody else caught my attention. Sometimes they could be kind of rude and cold, you know what I'm saying? But they down to earth, pragmatic. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're going to see her nature. You really going to see this. Not every child does this. But, you know, she gave her dad a hug and wrapped her arm around dad and looked at the camera and engaged to the audience. You guys going to find out the nature of a Leo dragon. The easy way or the hard way. Kind-hearted and giving. And, boy, sometimes I'm put in a situation where I could be embarrassing myself, looking really stupid, because I gave my daughter a book bag, and I didn't want to accept the fact that she didn't want the book bag and she gave it away. Sometimes she probably gave it away due to the kindness of her heart, probably because she didn't like it and she felt like somebody else deserved it and needed it. Me, I was blind to the fact that, you know, hey, you know, what gives? I gave you this. And she was young, you know what I'm saying? Young people who are natural born people could be manipulated and taken advantage of. And that's the reason why that they need somebody strong to defend them and put them in their place, because they could be tough. I'm telling you, they can be tough. And they will tell you about yourself and they will cut you. You know what I'm saying? There was plenty of times when my daughter cut me, man. Cut my heart. And it took me a while to heal. Mentally and spiritually, it took me a while to heal. But I bounced back and she let me know, like, hey, you know, you dad and I love you. But sometimes when she's with a group of friends, she's like, dad, stay out the way. And it's like, damn. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes that shit hurts when you get dismissed like that. But this is a lot to read. You guys can read this on your own. Let's see. Perfect careers for Leo Dragon. Editing, legal, music, fashion, and editing. And me and my daughter, which is a Leo Dragon, we actually did a little song together. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to play a little snippet of that real quick for you. Let you know that, you know, just because she ended up being a musician, an artist, it's a high possibility because, you know, me and her was on the microphone. We did a song together. This right here is called Fresh Tarragon. This is what we did. Yep. So that's her in the background. So we was on, we used the software called Audacity. And, you know, she was a little bit shy, but hey, she it didn't take her long for her to get in with it. So she took the microphone and did her thing. And I was like, you know, we're going to do a song called Fresh Tarragon, and she did, and she helped me open up the song in the beginning. So she dropped a little few words here. So she likes music. Look at that. So that's her little inch, her little thing there. Let's see what the comments look like. Hey, people loved it. People loved it. You know, of course I'm not famous or popular, but you know, she actually added some attention to my channel. She definitely did. She definitely put some sauce on the channel. And I type in Fresh Tarragon and I popped up. Let's see, what's the next one? But yeah, that's just to show you proof that, you know, they are into music, editing, you know, whatever. Get along very well. So they're compatible with Gemini Snake. Interesting. Libra Monkeys. Aries Rat. Sagittarius Monkey. And Aries Snake. Celebrities under these signs. Patrick Swayze. If I'm not under, this could be the guy from Star Trek. I don't know. Let me see. Oh, Lord. Let's find out who Patrick Swayze is. That's Patrick Swayze. Look at the face. Did the movie called Dirty Dancing. Y'all see that? Let's go to some more of them. Let's go to my daughter real quick, because I've been talking a lot about her.
Faith and I. All right, we are live on YouTube.
She copying me. Yep, she says it feels nice hanging out with her dad. All right. Eggnog soda. So this is the reaction I get hanging out with a Leo dragon.
Hey, how's it going? Good, you got...
The mighty faith is about to try out the eggnog soda. About to be. Stir it up real good, girl. Try it out. See what you think. Look at those bubbles and those ice in that straw. Oh my God. Go for it. Show the world that you have tried out one of the best drinks. The best soda. All right, come on, let's take a drink now.
You.
Nah, you do it. You are live on Hot Tazio Israel's YouTube channel.
Sorry, y'all, it's Hot Tazio.
Oh, come on, you can do it. You can do it. Put your mouth on it. Come on. Come on. You can do it. How old are you?
Six.
What's your name?
Faith.
All right. You can do it. You are so gorgeous, man. You look just like you too. Go ahead. Come on, pick up the soda and drink, girl. Please. Come on. We ain't got all day. We got a place to go.
Okay.
My battery's going dead.
Okay, fine.
Take a big,
big
gulp.
Look at my little Leo dragon.
I don't know if
take a big drink. I'm thirsty too. I'm gonna try it out. What you think? I'm gonna show you what I'm about. Like a bar soap.
It does.
What the hell do we just drink?
What the heck did we just drink? You guys, we are weak.
And also, I pointed out another thing. She's very intelligent. The Leo dragons are very intelligent. And I'm just wanted to just to play to a part where she actually talks.
all came together and they have stuff.
Is that right?
Yes, when...
Why? Why do they hate that a father and daughter spend time with each other and they love each other? Can you tell the world that? Show the world why people, it's just very irritating. I mean, wives didn't want nothing to do with me and you, but nothing.
People?
Yeah, they don't like what me and you have going on.
People do not like the story, so they don't like what people say.
About what? How come they don't like me and you hanging out together?
About videos, they don't like them.
You know what the video says, that sometimes they can say things that are harsh. It's very true. Leo dragons can say some harsh things, but they're being very realistic. For real.
Me and you together when we are talking together and they have stuff. Yes, when they don't like
videos, spend time together, yeah. Go to the library.
Yeah.
I tell you, man, me and you got one of the best father and daughter relationships on the planet. I haven't met no one else who has a good father and daughter relationship like me and you.
Yes, when.
So why do we have a good relationship like we do?
Because.
Explain that one. Yeah. Please do.
Because everybody does not like our videos and nobody likes our videos.
That's sad. They don't like our videos. I think we deserve hella views. I think we deserve millions and thousands of views. But you got people always on the other pages. You got videos that last 4 seconds and they got 5 billion views. Something stupid.
The only people that like our videos is Papa and Daddy.
We only got like 48 subscribers. I think we need about 300, 400, 500 subscribers. We be posting some real stuff. We got some of the dopest music on there.
We need 1,500.
Yeah, we do. I agree. Okay, so we can catch mad footage. Get that right. Mad footage on YouTube.
Yeah.
There's situations we ran into like that the phone was dead and we should have been like, damn, we should have recorded that footage. We love YouTube though. People get paid to have a YouTube channel.
I'll
tell you, listen. There are people who get subscribers, and their subscribers be paying them.
Sometimes people get like this, and people
they get hella views, hella support. And look, all I want to be is a homeowner and take care of my daughter. I want to give her the best education, the best of what I can offer. But yes, the world is very tough out here for a black man. And for a black man to raise his kids the correct way. Because you got mad white supremacy out there.
See, she just like leaned her head on mine, man, so she actually felt where I was coming from, so she can relate with people. So Leo dragons, man, they definitely can connect very well with you, depending on you and your nature. You know what I'm saying? So that's just an example right there. Hopefully, you know, this video can go viral. You guys can find it and, you know, help a brother out. You know, I would love to see her again, and, you know, with your help, that can happen. I need good lawyers. You know what I'm saying? I just need help. Brother needs some help, man. I miss my Leo dragon, man. But let's see here. Sandra Bullock. I wonder who that is. Y'all know who she is. Name sound very familiar, though. Very sociable people person. You see, looks like she got a group of friends. Okay, let's see this. Stupid commercials. There's a possibility that I'm getting a glimpse of what her nature is like when she's older. Let's see. Just to let you know, the focus is not on her talking. It's not. But it's just to show you that, hey, you know, they ain't gonna have a hard time finding groups of friends to kick it and chill with. I mean, look at the reaction she got out of me, a grown man. It's not good to underestimate people, man. It is not. Some people, man, they just get a different response or reaction than most. Let's continue. Let's see who else. Sorry, that's so quiet. This is. Dang, I done caught that little bag. Good catch. But this is a very sensitive sign that I'm breaking down. So I apologize if it's very lengthy. Because, you know, this is a fantastic sign that has brought the best out of me, man. You know what I'm saying? Let's see. Mary Louise Parker, huh? Look at that. Let's see what she's talking about. Hope I don't get no copyright strike with that. Wow, why is she looking like that? Oh my gosh, please. All right, let's see the rest of them. See, already I'm getting a reaction out of most of them. See the comments. And y'all see, they do dress pretty well. They dress pretty well. So the way my daughter was dressed, man, it really, you know, brought out her nature, her spirit. You know what I'm saying? She looked very clean. She ain't look dusty. You know what I'm saying? And like, I really, really felt the bond and the connection. She didn't seem like she was forced or felt forced to hang around me. You know, she was very chill, she was relaxed, and it was amazing. It was amazing, man. Hey, this video is like literally an hour. I do apologize, y'all. Some of y'all videos will be like under 30 minutes, sometimes 10, 6. But you know, everybody ain't the same. And when you also read the articles, some of those articles, paragraphs be super daggone long. You know what I'm saying? Like some signs you actually know when you have felt, like even though you haven't melt them, some signs, you know, will bring something out of you. You know what I'm saying? Like they will bring it out. And it will just blow your mind. It will blow your mind. My mind has been disintegrated. You know? And even when I went to Job Corps, you know, I was and was thinking about advanced training. Something told my spirit, don't go nowhere else. Go back to Ohio. Go back to Columbus. Come back to Columbus. And I did that. And I came back to Columbus, and I have had the best connection with another human being that I helped put on this earth. It was the best. Hopefully I have, you know, more connections like that, but you know, that's something I will never forget for the rest of my life. My childhood was bumpy, it was shaky, but as soon as she was born, as she aged and got older and we connected, you know, I felt like, you know, I had a childhood. I actually felt what it was like to have a childhood when she was born on this earth. And some people, they that's the reason why they won't let me have custody of my daughter, because she's so influential. She's so powerful. She's a powerhouse. You know what I'm saying? The mom didn't even want me to have custody of her. She was that potent. You know what I'm saying? The grandma, she didn't want me to have custody of her. She was that potent. She was that powerful. So just to let you know, you Leo dragons, man, I'm telling you. You know how to bring a person back from the dead, from the inside. When a person feels dead inside, you able to revive them back to life. And that's a shout out to all of y'all out there. I don't know all of y'all, but some of y'all may rub me the wrong way. But if you a Leo dragon and we get to talking and kicking it, you know what I'm saying? You may get the same response that my daughter gave me and I gave to her. Let's see, Josh Schwartz. So far, a lot of Leo dragons been having this this bubbly, cool nature about them. You know what I'm saying? It's amazing. Look at that face right there, so attentive, just looking, studying. You know what I'm saying? That spirit that's on y'all, it's just like, wow. It's mind blowing. All right, let's go to the next one here. Josh Schwartz. Look at that. He got three women behind him just looking at him. They smiling. You got the one with the blonde hair looking at his crotch. You got the one behind him looking at the camera trying not to, you know. Let's see. Let's check this out, man. Man, to hell with commercials. Oh my God, I hope I don't get no copyright strike off commercials. I need my YouTube channel. Look at that. I don't need your commentary. No, thank you. I'm cool on that. Look at this. Look at what this guy got on, man. Looking like Jim Carrey off the Cat in the Hat. I mean, Jim Carrey off the mask. You gotta put on your mask! See, look at the spirit that the Leo Dragons put on people. Look at this. It, like, dude literally just lit his show up. Let's see what they're talking about. Let's see the latest comments. All right, so that's it. Let's see what else we got on here. Good leader, and hope you guys enjoyed that, man. Like, comment, and subscribe. I know this video has been lengthy. My battery about to die, but thank y'all so much for tuning in. Peace.